Noa ia e Māori, whakalofalahi atu, tālofa, welcome to Tangata Pasifika.
Nisampulu vinaka, mālo ne, on the show today. Pacific Islands Education Ministers converge on the super city.
There's a sense of we can do this together, and I think we need to be very strong on that.
We catch up with the Wellington choir that's competing in the United States later this year.
We had groups go before us that had done this craft and it was all unfamiliar, but it actually inspired us, so we all decided to have a go at it.
And we meet the apprentice sewing machine mechanic, showing age is no barrier when it comes to upskilling.
My first year as an apprentice, it was really hard. I was thinking of chucking everything in.
Nice. Kapuna Māori. Now, a group of New Zealand judges and lawyers will travel to Samoa early next month to run a workshop for local lawyers. The two-day jury trial workshop is a first for Samoa and for the Pacific, providing advice, tips and practical feedback to their Samoan colleagues. Senior defence lawyer and organising group member Marie Dyberg KC says it's a chance to share knowledge.
It's really imparting our experience, our skills, our learnings in a very, very productive way so that we demonstrate what we do, but we also, the participants, shock, horror them, all be very nervous, but they get to demonstrate as well. And we critique and say, look, good, but this is how you can do better. So it's very much an interactive way of learning. It's a workshop.
Unlike Crown Councils, our local lawyers seldom get the opportunity to develop their trial and litigation skills.
And back here now, and Pasifika Futures, the whānau ora commissioning agency for Pacific families, wrapped up their conference in Auckland this week. It had not been held since before the pandemic, and Board Chair Dr. Kiki Mawate says the conference was an opportunity to reconnect and reflect. The theme for the conference was Ka Wainga Nā Koanga O, Navigating New Waters, and speakers and guests got an opportunity to give their insights into the Pacific response throughout the COVID-19 pandemic and recent natural disasters.
At the Waiwolo. To Tonga now, where the body of former Prime Minister Reverend Dr. Pohiva Tuionetoa will return to the kingdom from the United States this weekend for a service and burial. The 71-year-old passed away on the 18th of March in California, where he was seeking medical assistance. Elected to Tonga's parliament in 2014, he became the 17th Prime Minister of Tonga in 2019, following the passing of former Prime Minister Akilisi Pohiva. Despite retaining his seat at the 2021 election, he was unable to return as Prime Minister.
And finally, to sport, the Moana Pasifika Super Rugby team might be playing the Hurricanes in Auckland this weekend, but nice. It's their game against the Queensland Reds next month that many fans are looking forward to. That's because it will be played in Apia, Samoa, nice. And tickets for the April 14 match go on sale next week. Fans and families are encouraged to secure their tickets early to avoid disappointment, and tickets are limited. Find them at all digisale stores in Samoa, and ticket prices start from $10.
I'm just getting our tickets now. To our first story, and Pacific leaders gathered in Auckland this week for the inaugural Pacific Education Ministers Conference to discuss pressing education challenges in the region.
As Anauli Karima Fai reports, it was an opportunity for New Zealand to learn from their Pacific neighbours about how to improve education outcomes here in Aotearoa.
It's the first time these Pacific leaders have been able to meet in person since the COVID pandemic started. For this inaugural conference on Pacific education held in Auckland this week.
You are part of us. We are family.
It was an opportunity to discuss solutions such as climate change, gender equity and COVID-19.
A lot of the issues here were very informative, even as a minister who's been looking after education for a while in Tonga.
Tonga's Prime Minister Huakava Meiliku Siaosi Sovaleni says meeting with other leaders has uncovered possible solutions to Tonga's education challenges.
We have issues about trying to limit dropouts and truancy. We like to actually invest more in that so that we can actually try and keep the students in the classroom.
Teacher shortages are also an issue in the Pacific, with many moving to New Zealand for better working conditions.
I believe it's important for New Zealand and Australia to work with us, not only for those that we're sending over, but also for the training institution to actually build up our capacity and capability to also sustain and maintain the level of service in Tonga or in any of the Pacific countries.
I'm looking forward to a constructive dialogue guided by the principles of collaboration.
New Zealand Education Minister Jan Tanetti was also present.
One of our key priorities is to ensure that places of learning are inclusive and free from discrimination and racism.
She says there's a lot New Zealand can learn from its Pacific neighbours.
What I'm learning here is that there's a sense of we can do this together. And I think we need to be very strong on that, that it's not just about us alone. All of us together as Pacific Island Ministers of Education can make a difference for our Pacific Island students.
And with the growing number of Pasifika people in New Zealand, collaboration with the islands is crucial.
What it means for us here in New Zealand is that our Pacific children will benefit from this, because we'll take our lessons from here and we will put that into the refresh of the Pacific Education Plan to ensure that all of our young people are succeeding.
Hoʻeiki pea moe kāinga, stay with us. When we come back, we talk Niue arts in Aotearoa.
And later, why age is no barrier when it comes to upskilling on the job.
I'm thankful and happy. My mind is set to finish this course. Given my age, you know, it's really an awakening call for me to start something new. And it's brilliant.
For 30 years, the Pasifika Festival has been a staple within our Pacific community here in Auckland, New Zealand, showcasing our different Pacific cultures and our different Pacific food. So today we thought we'll join along and see what some of our stores have in store for us today and hopefully get a free feed.
We're Ocean's Pulling, so we're selling pulingi, puteni, if you call it in Tongan. So it's made with cinnamon, lots of love, served with custard, and we've got waters, and yeah, just keep you hydrated.
Nene ana woman fa na ole island style papa ke ya ma fa nei nga ruena ma so sani fo I ai ka ko kanaka.
We've done the Pacifica for a few years now, and it never fails to you know, appease everybody, brings out all the cultures and everybody, which is really awesome.
So we managed to get a couple of food down here at the Pasifika Festival. Shout out to the island style barbecue and also the O'Shea's custard pudding. But first off, we're going to have to try this island style barbecue. So we've got a bit of everything here. We've got the lamb chop, the sausage, the chop suey, and also a bit of potato salad, a bit of coleslaw. So yeah, we'll see how it goes. That's so nice, that's so nice. So I kind of like how my mouth is a bit looking yuck right there. Kind of like the flavours, how they all sort of join in together. I like how the coleslaw and the potato salad, they complement the barbecue, the lamb chops and the sausages. So that's what you need for the perfect barbecue. So overall, I think I'll give it a 10. And plus they gave it to us for free, so yeah, give it a 10. Shout out to Island Style Barbecue. You can find them at the night markets, and you can also see them on Instagram and on their social medias on Facebook. So we've also got the O'Shea's custard pudding, which you can also find them on Instagram. I think for me personally, the custard pudding is what really takes me back home to Samoa. You know, gives a bit of a mind about my grandma when she used to make this for us. But yeah, we're gonna have a taste about it. So personally for me, I just want the custard of the pudding to not be too thick. I think if it's too thick, then I think it'll be a waste of pudding. So if you look at the pudding here that the team at O'Shea's have provided, I really like sort of the nice, it's not too thick and it really complements the pudding there. So we're gonna have a taste and yeah, see how it is. And she'll just grab it with our hands, you know, Samoan style, you know. I really like that, yeah. It's nice, it's nice. I really like how the pudding is not too sweet and like I said, it's not too thick. So yeah, again, we gotta give it a 10 out of 10. You can find them on Instagram, O'Shea's Pudding. And yeah, come on down to the next time they're around for our next Pasifika Festivals. Pasifika.
Whakalopulahi atu, welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. The Falepipi he Mafola Niuean Arts Group is celebrating 30 years with a special exhibition of 300 works at the Mangere Arts Centre in April. Joining us now to speak more about the significance of this milestone for Niuean art is founding member Molly Pihingia and fellow member Janita Tiatia. Welcome to you both. Thank you for coming on the program. Whakaulahi.
Whakaulahi atu, Marama.
Tell us a little bit about your group, first of all. You're a founding member. You have been meeting every week since the early 90s at the Aotearoa Town Hall.
Every Thursday since 1993, we meet there to do everything about Niue and things to do with Aotearoa as well.
Now, I understand over the years you've been coming together, creating these beautiful works like you have in your ears right now. You have amassed about 300 pieces, which I understand you've been keeping at your house since that time.
Yes, that's right. I mainly specialise in weaving stories into wall hanging.
Okay.
And I'm trying to teach the young ones and also people to weave their stories into their work.
Now, tell us about this exhibition that's coming up. Although it's been sitting in your house, I don't know how you've been able to fit 300 pieces in your home, Molly, but there's an opportunity for people. We can see some of the stuff coming up on the screen now. Tell us about the exhibition that's going to be bringing together all these pieces.
The exhibition has been done by all the people of Falepipi and Mafola. Some of them have passed on, and some we are still lifting up the heritage art of Niue. And it's really wonderful to keep the culture alive.
What does it mean to you to have this exhibition?
It means a lot to me because 30 years I walk with the older people, and some has passed on, and learning from them as well, learning the culture, learning the behaviour, learning the heritage of Niue.
Janet, tell us about your involvement in the exhibition.
My involvement is through my mum, Molly's husband is Fata Fateiki Bihingia, which is my mother's brother. So that's where I come in when she come from Niue and then join Molly every Thursday.
And you've got some pieces that are in this exhibition as well?
Yes, during the journey, Molly and Fata taught us how to weave tray baskets using cane. And then a piece I did last year and the year before was for my learning resource for a patch of teaching that I'm undergoing at the moment for my studies.
How important is it for you to be keeping your culture alive? Now I'm looking at some of the language stats for the Wangahau Niue in New Zealand in terms of our young people speaking it. For New Zealand-born Niueans, only 12% of our people speak Niuean. Tell us about how important it is for you to be keeping the culture alive here.
It's very important because that's who I am. It's very important for young people to get that passion, to know who they are. And you can only do that with your family, with the community, Niuean community, and to have a real desire to learn, to keep it up, your culture, because I don't know if, gonna be any longer. So it's up to the young people now to try and use the opportunity to learn.
How hard is it to get the young people involved and come along?
It's very difficult now. I find it very difficult for younger people, and I know they have busy lives, busy working, busy studying, but let's make time. Give some time to learn about the heritage. It's very important to know who you are as a Niuean.
Now, next weekend, you've got this opening of the exhibition. People can come along and see these incredible works by you guys. Tell us what's going to be happening at the launch.
Well, the launch, it's the opening of the 300 pieces, and there will be groups I have invited the Niuean community groups. I've invited them to come and see the beauty of our culture. And there are other people from other nations are coming as well to see the Niuean heritage.
Okay, it's going to be a real celebration. I can't wait to see it. Congratulations on the incredible work that you are doing for the exhibition, both of you, and also for all the work you've been doing for your group as well. Whakauelahi.
Whakauelahi malama for giving us this opportunity to be here, and whakauelahi ke mtunrosi kua mamata mai ke pongipongi nei.
Whakauelahi. Whakauelahi. Well, after the break, sewing machine apprentice Peni Panapa, but next the Wellington Choir taking barbershop to new heights.
I think for us it's taking everything that we've learnt, that our parents have taught us, that our grandparents have taught us, and taking those opportunities and turning them into something that we love to do, and then sharing that with the rest of the world.
Hello, Loketa. Welcome back to Tagata Pasifika. To music now, and a choir in Wellington is the first Pacific-based chorus to break a New Zealand competition record and qualify to compete at a barbershop competition in Louisville, Kentucky this July.
Around 35 singers are self-funding their trip to represent Aotearoa New Zealand, but also the Pacific region. John Pulu has more.
Their Pacific songs sung in the barbershop style. They're known as the Pacific Connection Choir, formed 4 years ago by members who resonated with a cappella music.
People from our local community just love to sing, you know, and what better opportunity than to bring them together in this awesome little ensemble we have going, and looking forward to taking them overseas.
They won the 2022 National Barbershop title and qualified to represent New Zealand this July at the International Barbershop Harmony Society competition in Louisville, Kentucky.
So we'll be going up against people who have been in this game for a very, very long time. And us as a very new choir with some experience in there, but also just experience from singing in church, we love to bring that on the stage and our culture, and so they can see who we are, who really are.
Now we want to get straight to the round. Now what we're doing is we're taking that time.
The Wellington-based choir of around 30-plus members is made up of students, artists, lawyers and health professionals who just love to sing.
We had groups go before us that had done this craft and it was all unfamiliar, but then we saw them do their thing on stage, groups like Southern Harmony, Musical Island Boys, it actually inspired us, so we all decided to have a go at it, and the rest is history now. This is where we are.
Sometimes I think about where I was from.
They already started on a high note as the first chorus to sing in Pacific languages on a barbershop contest stage.
Not only am I singing in my own languages, I get to embrace everyone else's cultures around me, and I think it's so important, especially for us New Zealand born.
We come as the Waswasavata, the one ocean. We take that with us, so while we represent New Zealand, we also take our countries, our families, our ancestors with us.
Although predominantly Pacific, the vocalists are from all backgrounds.
I know we have the talent in our area, and I joined for a few reasons, to make connections with my children, my wife and my wife's family, and the other beautiful families of Cannons Creek, but also to show the world and make a statement that people from Cannons Creek can succeed.
Also in the choir is the Esera family, who will take part in another category at the competition.
It's a lot to carry, it's a lot to represent, but we're just happy that we get to compete as siblings on stage as a quartet.
On their way to the event, the musos will stop by New York for a special show. All up, the costs, including the Big Apple, comes with a big price tag.
We're trying to raise a lot of money, so it's about $280,000 in total to get us all there, which includes flights, accommodation, function room hire, coaching costs. So it's a lot of money, but it's hopefully going to be all worth it.
They've set up a Give a Little page and participated in community fundraisers to get them closer to the US.
I think for us, it's taking everything that we've learnt, that our parents have taught us, that our grandparents have taught us, and taking those opportunities and turning them into something that we love to do, and then sharing that with the rest of the world in an art form that is not necessarily ours, but something that we've taken and put our spin on it.
Taking our Pacific harmonies to the world.
Beautiful.
I've joined the choir.
Oh,
too.
Yes, you no, know. You should.
They had to chase me out, actually. To the trades now, where industry training organisation Competence Te Pūkenga is helping Pasifika and Māori upskill on the job.
Now, one person nearing the end of an apprenticeship to upskill is Tokelauan Peni Panapa, who at 51 will become a fully qualified sewing machine mechanic. Suana Aholele has the story.
There's no sleeping on the job here at the Comfort Group factory in Otahu. Many of those working on the floor have been here for years. Group operations manager Cameron Turner knows all too well what it's like working here. A family business, he's been helping in the factory since he was in his teens.
In this factory here, just a little over 120, but we currently employ around 1,200 people across Australia and New Zealand.
In 2021, a new initiative with the help of training provider Competence Te Pūkenga was introduced to the company.
One of the things that we pride ourselves in this business is that someone might have not been working in the business for very long, but they see a fellow employee climb the ranks of the company right in front of them, and they see that as an opportunity.
And taking the opportunity to upskill is Tokelauan, Peni Panapa, who's been with the company for 18 years.
When he mentioned to me that the course is run by Pasifika and the group is Pacific people, I was happy that I will be with some of my own cultures.
Peni admits upskilling has been difficult at times.
My first year as an apprentice, it was really hard. I was thinking of chucking everything in and go back on the floor or something. The language barrier with the written materials that were sent to me, it was really difficult. And myself, I never asked questions.
Through his tutor and translator, he found help with a study group.
I think that was the lifeline that got me back on the horse. And now I can ask the questions and I understand now what's needed to be done.
The father of four is now in his final year in his apprenticeship, his boss noticing the confidence in Peni.
I think that change happened probably a year, just over a year in. Maybe halfway through the course, where you could see him going, actually, you know, my skills are starting to grab. And he was getting that feeling of accomplishment when he came to work and he was confident in what he was doing. So definitely seen that change.
And Competence Te Pukenga pleased with Penny's progress too.
We're really dedicated to providing equitable outcomes for all of our learners. So creating a space like the Pasifika Learner Support Group is really helpful for learners like Peni to have a safe environment to ask the questions they need and talk about anything that they want to relating to the course and be able to have that help that they need to get them through.
I'm thankful and happy. My mind is set to finish this course. Given my age, you know, I'm in fresh off the boat. I've never been in New Zealand before. I never go to school in New Zealand. But it's really an awakening call for me to start something new. And it's brilliant.
Malo, malo, Peni.
Well, that's the end of our show. Remember, you can watch the stories again on tpplus.co.nz or TVNZ Plus.
Stay up to date with the latest news. Just go to our social media platforms. And if you have a chance, you saw our wonderful mātua, Molly Pihingia, earlier. Come along and support our mātua, Falepipi, ha Mafola, with their amazing exhibition at the Mangere Arts Centre called Whenonga Taonga Niue I Aotearoa, Niue Heritage Journey in Aotearoa.
Puluola. And also the Cyclone Gabriel fundraiser concert, Marama, is on TVNZ2 today from 11 to 7 p.m. with a great lineup of artists. For now, have a great weekend, Aotearoa. Me taki atu paka, ka kite.
Koe ki au. Tō pasifika.
To our new homebound, Tangata Pasifika, born a people proud, people of the sun, to our new homebound.